So this caught my eye. There are a lot of Obama advisors out there, Ryan, who are taking a very good and a very positive look at the Lincoln Project, which, as you know, is run by a bunch of neocon ex-Republicans like Steve Schmidt, Rick Wilson, who I've exposed as a charlatan here on the show several times. And so they want progressives to emulate the Lincoln Project. This first tweet came from James Slattery. Let's throw it up there on the screen. So James Slattery is an ex-Obama administration advisor, and he's saying progressives really should be taking notes on what the Lincoln Project is doing because their ads are straightforward, powerful, and gripping. Let's take a listen, and then we're going to get your reaction, Ryan.
It didn't come easy. It didn't come quickly. And it didn't come without great sacrifice.
America will again and soon be open for business. We cannot let the cure be worse than the problem itself. We're not going to let the cure be worse than the problem.
Haven't we asked enough of the greatest generation? The Lincoln Project is responsible for the content of this advertising.
I don't even think that's particularly great of an ad there, Ryan. And yet what this guy is really saying is, hey, progressives, you guys should become more like the neocon, never Trump Republicans. It's kind of amazing, isn't it?
Yeah. They've done some great ads. That wasn't one of them.
No, it wasn't even good.
I think one thing that these liberals need to keep in mind is the amount of material that Trump is giving these folks. So, because somebody's able to hit, softball batting practice pitches over the fence doesn't mean that they could compete in an actual campaign head-to-head against a well-funded and articulate challenger who hasn't sown chaos all around the globe. Now, Democrats have always loved when Republicans attack Republicans, and particularly Democrats who are into their 40s and 50s and above, because those Democrats spent the 1980s and the 1990s being told that they were unpatriotic, that they were traitors, that they were backstabbers who cost the victory in Vietnam, that their taxes spent liberals.
It's like a McGovern effect, right?
Yeah, and Sarah Palin with the real Americans. Mm-hmm. Like that, she says it out loud, but that's what Republicans were saying about Democrats, that Republicans were real Americans. Democrats were a Fed that used to be latte-drinking Starbucks, Volvo-driving people. Then everybody started drinking lattes. So now, then they moved on to wine. Now everybody drinks wine.
But Frappuccinos.
Frappuccinos.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like whatever the thing is that liberals are doing, and liberals internalize that and become self-hating around their liberalism and their progressivism.
Sure.
And so when somebody else agrees with them, who is a self-identified real American and identified by Republicans, then they absolutely love that's going on. They really wanted Colin Powell, to run for president back around that time.
I forgot about that. Yeah, that's true.
They would have put John McCain on as like a VP or something. They have this fixation. Now, if you're under 40, and you came of age after this Reagan era, you don't have that defensiveness. You don't have that lack of self-confidence in your politics. And so it makes it so confusing to see this unfold. Now, on the other hand, a lot of Democratic consultants are very bad at making ads. Amy McGrath's campaign spent $30 million in Kentucky during the primary. And so with that kind of money, you're going to be able to hire the best consultants around the country. Just go look at the ads that her team produced.
Yeah,
it's her looking at the camera. The George Floyd ad in particular, didn't mention Breonna Taylor when she's running in
right in the state of Kentucky.
Didn't mention he was killed by police. Bizarrely talked about how she's a mother and so she understands. Mm-hmm. But that was just one of them. They're all terrible.
Right. I think it's a good example. I think the reason I wanted to highlight it is because Crystal in particular gets so annoyed by these Dems, like these Obama people, be like, you should really learn from Rick Wilson's outfit and what they're criticizing Trump on. And it's like, at their core, the Lincoln Project is annoyed at Trump for not being more neoconservative and not being, even as economically right as this administration has, not being economically right enough. Like, people should not forget what exactly these people stand for. And I think it's funny because the Obama people in general just seem to have this entire, they've read the primary wrong because I think they're very arrogant over Joe Biden's win, for his ultimate win. And this is something Breonna Joy Gray points out, which is that on Pod Save America, I think in a recent episode, they said, quote, a lot of voters really liked Bernie Sanders, they really liked Elizabeth Warren, and they really liked Kamala Harris. Now, the latter two is just not, you know, it's just not true. As she says, only one of those people won a single state. The candidates had wildly different appeal amongst actual voters, and the show just refuses to acknowledge that. I mean, why is it, Ryan, that because Biden won, that they seem to have whitewashed just so much of what actually happened during those months? I mean, there was a long period where nobody thought that he was going to be anything, and that a very different thesis out of this primary was going to emerge.
And the irony is that those guys were not Biden fans.
No,
like
yeah.
They're
like Buttigieg people.
They know Biden.
Right.
You know, they worked with Biden.
Yeah.
They were not.
Yeah.
They're not excited about Biden. They didn't think that Biden was going to win. Their audience is, suburban white women.
Yeah, it's like resistance crowd.
And so among those, if you just narrow it down to them, then those numbers do become true. That in within their audience, Kamala Harris had a decent number of supporters. Warren in September was. Was practically hiring White House staff.
Right.
You know, she was on her way to the nomination until she fell apart in the fall. So from that perspective, they say, well, a lot. And a lot is hinging on the word a lot there. There are a lot of Democrats, thousands, tens of thousands.
Yes. Not millions, right.
But this idea that Kamala Harris is popular, it was shown to be a myth during the campaign, but persists. Today, you know, like she didn't make it even to Iowa, but yet she appears to be one of the top two or three, most likely to be attached to the Biden campaign. So this kind of narrative that these are all popular Democrats has real implications for that Veep stakes.
Oh, it's just funny. Yeah, we'll talk about the Veep stakes later in the show, and we're gonna have more Rising for you after this.